Hello, I would like to introduce the Tao language, a functional reactive language for real-time 3D animation. This is the kind of things you can do with Tao, and this is how you do it. I simply change the text here, and you can see the update in real-time on the left. So what can you do with Tao? The first thing is you can draw a number of graphic elements in 2D and 3D. This is how we do it, and that's going to illustrate what I call the functional aspect of Tao. You can pass code as easily to function as text or numbers. This is how the show shape function is defined. This operator here means transforms into. So it means you should transform any code that looks like this into the code on the right. In that case, I got the body argument, which was the code, like this one or this one here. And this is passed as an argument. And then the show shape function in turn passes that same argument to add position, but inside a larger block of code, like this. So that's how you use code as function arguments, and that's the functional aspect of Tao. Now, I said that Tao is reactive. What does that mean? Well, it means you can have code that depends on external events, such as mouse movement, for instance, and simply specifying this dependency is enough to have the code react to this input. Same thing with time here. As soon as I add a time dependency, I create a time-based animation. So that's very simple. Tao also has loops and other regular structures, often found in many programming languages. So here we have three for loops on x, y, and z, between values minus 5 and 5. So that's a little over 1,000 cubes being drawn here, except we cut that in half with this test here. And so all this looks very familiar, but what's interesting is how this is done inside. This if here, for instance, is defined with this code over here that says if you have code that looks like if then, and the first argument is true, then you evaluate the true body. And if the first argument is false, then you return the value false. And that's how you define the if then else. So if you have false, then you execute the false body. And these are the actual definitions of if then else, the one that is being used here. So as you can see, this mechanism is much more powerful than the plain old function definitions in other languages. Now, because this is a functional language, you also have the ability to do things like mapping values over ranges of parameters. And so here, for instance, we call draw shape repeatedly with arguments rect, then oval, then glob, then triangle. So this with operator here maps this argument list onto draw shape. So that's the case for a rectangle, and that's the general case, which we use for the glob case here. And that's why you see this text glob with a question mark. Again, this mechanism is very powerful, and you can use it for ranges of values, like this, where we draw all circles between minus 50 and minus 10, and then all between 20 and 50 on the right here. But because we have special case, the case for 22, now we draw a rectangle for the value of 22 as input. Again, this mechanism can be used with arbitrary notations. We use that for if then else and others, but everything you see here, like picture slide, for instance, is defined exactly that way. So in that scenario here, we have defined this special notation. And when I use the notation over here, 2 maps onto A and 5 maps onto B, and that block here maps onto X. Here, 5 maps onto A, 10 onto B, and that block over here, so indentation-based block, maps onto X. can also use this mechanism for viable argument lists. So here we have this broad chart where we pass a number of values separated with commas. And you see that if you have a single value, a single number, it's going to draw a rectangle. But if it has a comma-separated value, it's going to draw the first one and then keep going with the rest. So for that list, the first one is a number, so we call that, and the rest is this list, so we iterate over until we have exhausted the list. This mechanism is used here to define min and max in the same recursive way. So the min and max you have here work with any number of arguments and with any type. You know, it can be number or it can be text. Now, when you draw things, you can change, you basically specify change in colors or in geometry. And the locally keyword here, or it's a function really, keeps things local inside the block. So that draw step here does a rotation, translation, or color change, but these do not leak outside of the locally here. By contrast, this draw step here accumulates, it's the same code, but now the changes accumulate, and the circle at the end has the color of the last step. So that's what locally is, and it's very, very useful. You can draw pictures or images, like that's how you show a JPEG picture. You can also format text. So this is the notation used in Tao for first level bullet points, second level bullet points, third level bullet points, and you see them here. And because this is all reactive, I can do things like this. And you see that the number of seconds is shown added at the end of the text. The text justification mechanism is very powerful, and you see that it lets us do full or partial justification between, you know, completely full justification and no justification at all. And it lets us do alignment between left and right, same thing. So you can really do very fine-grained text layouts. That works with 3D text as well. You simply have to specify the depth of the text. And you can also change the radius of the bevel here. But again, you benefit from full justification or right-to-left text and other advanced features. You can display 3D objects very easily as well. In that case, I also added a translation here with variables tx and ty. So variables are defined just the same as functions with this rewrite operator. And now the main difference is that I have this colon equal that changes the value on the right. And now I can move my little piglet with the keys on my keyboard. So that's reactive, but applied to keyboard changes. Tao has a powerful mechanism for loading huge sets of data points. We can use colors as well. You see the mechanism is really reactive and really fast. So we use that to display more than 1 billion data points. We can also do some processing on the data. So here I'm doing some false color rendering on clouds, so data representing the stars in 3D, and that's the data file. Now the data file is reloaded every time you change it, so now if I remove data, it looks like this, and if I save again, you see that it reloads the data. So you can really use that for real-time data very easily. You can play back movies, set the movie volume, or use movies as textures. In that case, we are going to map it on a rounded rectangle, and we're playing back a movie straight from YouTube. Now, as long as you put them in textures, you can do more interesting things, like using shaders. So here I'm using a shader called Old TV Shader, defined over here, and it uses the shader program, loading a file called altv.fs. So let me look at that. And just like for my CSV files, when I change things, it happens in real time. So I can test shaders in complex dynamic environments very quickly. Can play multiple movies. So in that case, I'm loading 4 movies from YouTube directly. And that's because you never got enough minions in life. You can do text layout with text, with movie textures. And I use this here to get this broken glass effect fairly easily, again, from a YouTube movie. Now, this next bit of code is interesting because it does something in a given time range in a movie. So you're going to see what happens. We start the movie, and between second 38 and 42, it displays this loop mano bike coming from here. So now it's doing something based on the time of the movie.
Let the computer speed.
No effort. Great voiceover.
Finally, that's all it takes to have Tao speak for you, and probably wish I had used that given my accent, but I prefer to speak to you directly. So basically, that's what you can do with a Tao fairly easily, and if you want to have more information, please refer to our website, www.teodyne.com. Talk to you soon. Bye.